Hey guys, I'm Katie from Navigating Teen Life, and today we're going to be talking about how to eat healthy and stay healthy when you're super busy or starting a new transition into your life. Whether that's going to high school, starting after-school jobs, or any volunteering commitment, or even going to college.
When your schedule changes like this, it can really be a tough transition for some teens. You might have to pack extra snacks with you on the road, or you might have to go grocery shopping alone, or the exercise into a really tough schedule with a lot of stuff in it. So today we invited a registered dietitian from UPMC's Children's Community Pediatrics, Kris Rudolph, to help us on our discussion today.
Kris, what are some tips for making sure meals are actually healthy?
Well, it's easier than you think. Do you guys remember learning about the healthy plate in school? Have you all learned about it? But sometimes I think we learn about it in school, but we don't really know how to put it into practice. So one easy way to look at it is to think of the plate and the little sections almost like puzzle pieces. The different food groups are the puzzle pieces. The more food groups we have together, the more balanced the meal. You want to try it for 3 to 4 different food groups, and then you'll get a rounded out amount of nutrients, right? So let's say, for example, you're going to pack a lunch, okay? And I'm going to pick from a protein. So I might have turkey. I'm going to make it into a sandwich, have the grains. Then I'm going to add the fruits and vegetables, the carrots and the apples, and maybe throw in a yogurt or have some milk. And I just did it. It doesn't look exactly like the plate, but it's a roundabout of all the nutrients, all the different puzzle pieces together. Another really good way to look at it is to do it like a 50-50 rule, okay? Fill in that half section of fruits and vegetables. Fill that in first. So many times we want to put the main entree stuff on first. Fill in the fruits and vegetables first. Make those a priority, okay? Then you can fill in the other half with whatever else you're having. So it might be pizza, it might be the chicken tenders, but all of a sudden, if I put the fruits and vegetables on there, I just balanced it out.
Wow, I never thought about it like that.
So Kris, I'm going off to college next year and I've never gone grocery shopping by myself. Do you have any tips for me?
Yeah, me too.
Oh yeah. So what do you think the number one rule should be about grocery shopping?
Don't shop when you're hungry.
Yes, exactly. That's exactly what I was going to say. Why?
You'll buy a lot of junk food.
Yeah. You will. You'll sort of have these impulse buys, mm-hmm. and whatever looks good to you at that moment, you're going to buy. So number one, don't go hungry. The next thing is make a list. Lists really work. I know it is tedious to write it all down, but if you have a meal plan, make a list of the ingredients you need. You'll be more likely to stick with it. So a lot of times people will say shop on the outside of the grocery store. Why do you think that matters?
That's where the fresh stuff is.
Yeah, right? So it's like fresh produce, fruits and vegetables, meats, that kind of stuff. So you want to buy the stuff that's in season. So for example, right now, apples would be a great thing to buy in the produce section. Some things that might stay for a little bit longer. Now, what I want you to not discount is, I tell a lot of teenagers not to forget about the frozen stuff either. And by frozen, I mean frozen fruits and vegetables, okay? So when we were talking about the plate, we were talking about balancing it out. If you have a bag of, let's say, broccoli, like frozen broccoli, and you know you're gonna have a quick mac and cheese or something that you're gonna pull out because, you know, time is an issue, just take some frozen broccoli out of the freezer, put it in the microwave, boom, you've just added that to your plate of the mac and cheese and all of a sudden it's balanced out. So the frozen fruits and vegetables are super important. Other frozen foods, just make sure you look at the labels, really, of anything that's prepackaged. I mean, what do we know that could be hidden in a lot of this stuff? Lots of extra preservatives, lots of extra colorings, and lots of extra sugars. So the labels are really good right now. They've redone them so that everything is really clear to read. So just take a look, and you want to look at the ingredients. Should it have more ingredients or less ingredients? What do you think?
Less.
Yeah. Why?
And that means they didn't add all the extra stuff to it. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So less ingredients. Remember, the first ingredient that's listed is the one that's the most of a product, okay? So just keep that in mind when you're shopping. And then really have fun. Explore. Try new things.
That's all super awesome tips, so thank you.
So after school, I'm in a lot of activities such as theater and tennis. So if I want to stop at a restaurant or something, what do I do?
Well, that's a great question. Restaurant eating can be really tricky, but there's a way to get around it and stay healthy. So if you know the restaurants ahead of time, like if you were going to, you know, certain fast food restaurants or even sit down restaurants, if you know it ahead of time, go online, take a look at the menu and see what are better choices. A lot of them have, you know, calorie counts and calorie information on there. You don't necessarily have to look at that, but you can try to look at what might be the best choice that you can balance out and have something healthy. Then if you are going to a sit-down restaurant, do we think they're gonna give you a little bit or a lot? What's a restaurant gonna do?
A lot.
Right? They want you to come back. So they're gonna give you a lot of food. So any ideas of what you think you could do if you're going to a sit-down restaurant?
Maybe like only eat half of it and take the rest home.
Mm-hmm. Which is hard when it's sitting in front of you, right? So if you pre-plan, maybe you split the meal with someone. If you know it's gonna be really big, you can say, you know, hey, Katie, split this with me because I know they're gonna give us a lot. You can do that. You can ask for the to-go box right when you order. I know it sounds weird, but you can have it there and then kind of separate it out right away. That's another good idea. So another good tip is if you're at a restaurant and they have a lunch option available, you can always order the lunch portion or an appetizer portion of the food that you want. And it's gonna be smaller, but it might just be perfect for what you need. Mm-hmm. Does that sound like it would be something you guys could do?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, so the other thing is don't be afraid to try new sides, okay? So think about what typically is gonna come with a burger or chicken tenders?
French fries.
Right, and it's not a little bit of fries, it's a lot of fries. They're gonna take over the plate. So think about which one's your favorite. So I want the cheeseburger, I want the chicken tenders, or I want the fries. And pick one of those, and then don't be afraid to try new sides with it to balance it out. And again, going back to that whole plate thing, why I like it so much is because then if you pick a new side, there's maybe a side salad, maybe there's a yogurt, maybe, you know, there's fruit. You can balance it out and you can have a healthier meal when you're eating out. What do you think? Tips you guys might be able to use?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, yeah. Good.
So with softball, I have a really busy schedule after school. How do I make sure the snacks I'm eating in between practices and games are still healthy?
That's a great question too. So again, I'm going to go back to the plate. Think about a snack almost like a mini version of the plate, okay? So we talked about puzzle pieces, putting different parts together. So pick like maybe three parts of the plate. So maybe a little bit of protein to hold you over so that you're not hungry. Fruit or vegetable, because it's going to, again, have some fiber and water in it. And then maybe a whole grain with it. So for example, you could do an apple with peanut butter and a few pretzels. So right there, I pulled in three different food groups and made a mini version of the plate. You could do a pear, a piece of cheese, and some whole grain crackers. If it's gonna be really quick snack before you go, you want something light on the stomach, maybe just a piece of fruit or maybe just some, you know, whole grain crackers. But really, truly go back to the plate.
So personally, I'm allergic to peanuts and tree nuts, so sometimes I know that's a great substitute for protein, and if you need apples and peanut butter on the go, that's a really quick solution. So what things would you say I could substitute peanut butter with to give me that protein when I'm on the go and need a quick snack?
You brought up a great point about food allergies. I feel like there's a lot more kids out there that are struggling with the same thing. Mm-hmm. Another really good protein source is dairy, and cheese, yogurt, those are great sources to use, but also lean meats. We talked about even, you know, half of a sandwich or some lean cubes of deli meat that you can take and make sort of a cheese and meat and whole grain crackers kind of thing with too. So there are a lot of other sources aside from the peanuts, but I know that is a struggle. Mm-hmm. And for people that do struggle with it, the one thing that I think is really great now is that the food labels have done a really nice job of putting everything. Did you guys know that at the bottom of a food label in bold, if you're with someone that's allergic to something, they have to put in what the allergens are of the top six allergies. So you will see that at the end of the ingredient list on a label.
Thanks so much for the help and information today. If you have any more questions about balancing meals and eating healthy on the go, remember to ask your pediatrician or a trusted adult. And always, together, we're navigating teen life.